Hi guys, it's Jack in Nevada. Today we're going to be looking at the Natal range of drums consisting of the Ash kit, the Birch kit, and later on we'll be looking at the Maple and the Babinga kit as well. Moving on to the Natal Maple series drums, we've got these ones in C Sparkle with short stack toms. So basically what that is, instead of like normal 10x8 and 12x9, we've got this in 10x6.5 and 12x7. Basically what that does, makes like the toms more focused, and originally it was for positioning. If you notice, the toms are incredibly flat, quite low, so I can basically get over the drums. Looks cool, feels quite nice. You're at the right angle, you can play with proper technique. One of the best things about Maple is like the low end that you get off the drums, incredibly warm. In Nevada, it's basically like the majority of drums that we sell are going to be Maple for pro end kits. It's kind of like an industry standard for live and the studio. Again, great hardware all the way around. 7-ply shells. Also got 22x18 on this kit, 16x16, and again with a 14x5.5 matching snare, which is great. Sounds spanking. Kit overall comes as a shell pack, so you get all the shells that you can see here. The only hardware that you can see that comes with the kit are these two ball cast mounts, which are aluminium ball mounts, so you can get any kind of position. The ball's not going to wear out at all. Cymbals we're using today, I have a K Custom Special Dry Ride 21-inch, which is lovely, 17-inch A Custom Crash, we have an 8-inch Avidus Fast Splash, and we also have some 14-inch K Custom, no, normal K's actually, 14-inch K hi-hats. Finishes quickly. We've got black sparkle, copper sparkle, orange sparkle, green sparkle, silver sparkle, red sparkle, and the bigger flake, blue sparkle. As standard on all of the Natal kits, they come with Aquarian series galaxy heads, which have been made for the Natal kits. And basically, they're a 2-ply coated white head, nice and simple. You can tune them kind of like flexible tuning range. I mean, I've got this blue Maple kit tuned up a little bit higher, a bit more vintage, a bit more jazzy. And I've also like got stuff like brown sunburst kit that you've seen, and the ash kits that you've seen tuned up like to be like heavy rock, so nice flat low sound. So a nice like flexible head for a kit. Nice features about the kit that we really like at Nevada. You've got the three-way snare throw, which is included, so you've got three settings on there. Really impressed with the new lug holder design, really attractive. As you can see, all of the kit has the same hardware overall throughout the ranges, so it's only actually the woods that vary. I mean, everything from like the rubber underneath the lug holders, you've got triple flanged hoops just to increase the resonance overall. Moving on to hardware, we're going to look at the double-braced Pro Series boom stands that Natal have been putting out. Basically, it comes equipped base double-braced, massive rubber feet, so it's not going to go anywhere. Moving up to the central part of the stand, all equipped with memory locks, really solid, it's not going to move anywhere. One of the best features about the stand is that the pole will go inside the stand as well, so you can also lock it down and you can have it as a straight stand. Move it straight in, got yourself a straight stand so you can convert in between, and that's just all done from the one wing nut. Nice and simple. Another really good feature about the stand is the quick set tilter. One wing nut, undo the wing nut, it'll move anywhere you want it to go. Unlike other stands, the Natal Pro Series have been kind of built with a big player in mind, so if you like to jump up and crash your cymbals, these are the boys for you. Nice and tall. We're just going to have a look at one of the accessories from Natal. Really impressed with this one. It's Natal's dog and bone arm. Probably seen in like similar companies make ones before, but really impressed with this one. Basically, the attachment could go straight onto the arm of any boom stand from Natal. And basically, what that enables you to do is turn one cymbal stand into two attachments for any crash, ride, splash, Chinas, anything you like, out of one stand, thus saving floor space. Moving on to the Natal Pro Series hi-hat stand. Double braced again, two legs, so you've got room for any pedals that are going to sit either side. One of the best parts about this pedal is that it's nice and sturdy, memory locks are standard. At the bottom of the hi-hat stand, it's lever driven instead of using a chain, so you're not going to have any of the normal problems of the chain falling apart. As well as that, the response is a lot quicker than a normal chain, there's no give at all. Series snare drum stand. Same thing again, you've got a double brace base to the stand, memory locks are standard. One of the unique parts of this stand, similar to like the Tama DW kind of stands where it's mounted with a rubber ball joint, basically for positioning. You've also got a quick release there as well, with a nice big handle if I can show you. So just one movement and you can basically move it wherever you want. positioning. It'll also slide back and forth, I don't know if you can see that on the camera, on its post. So you can pretty much move the stand to any position that you want quite easily. You a quick overview of the pedals. These are the pro versions, so both pedals are equipped with double chain. We currently have the fast cams on board, which give you a faster action overall. Still quite powerful, really nice feel. There's a good weight in the beaters overall. You can use the felt side of the beater, or you can also switch around. If you want a harder sound, you can use the rubber side of the beater. Something quite unique that we found with these pedals. On a lot of the double pedals that we've seen, don't really get a good link between the two pedals. And one thing that's really impressed me is the actual connections between the two pedals. There's no lag in comparison to something like your Cobras or your DWs. There's just a more solid connection there, and it can move around freely overall. Another really cool feature is the base plate as well. Really big, thick base plates. Going to obviously keep your pedal stable, it's not going to move anywhere. Really big foot plates, so when you're playing at all different positions in the pedal to get different actions, you can move up and down depending on how quickly or how powerful you want your playing to be. All pedals come with a drum key on the side, and you can also attach the bass drum pedal from the side rather than having to put your hand right underneath to actually get through, which can be incredibly annoying. Other than that, you've got spring adjusters, both sides of the pedal, pretty much standard. And as well, you can obviously lock it into, if you've got a drum mat or anything, you can lock it straight in just by screwing these nuts straight the way through. It's a nice and easy, simple to use pedal. Let's take a look at the two different versions of the seats that we've got in stock at the moment. I have the Natal saddle motorcycle version. We also have a round top version. Both thrones are equipped with like a quick release on the side, which basically enables you to unclip. Screw it out. So it's nice and easy to adjust the position. And when you're done, clipped, done. Also on the base of the stand, it's double braced again, with nice big feet, so you're not going to move anywhere as you're playing on some of the slippery floors. All in all, it's a nice, comfortable, solid stool. Give you a quick overview of some of the percussion that we stock in store. Natal, obviously starting out as a percussion brand, been going since 1965 making percussion. Been really popular in store, just where it's at a really good price point, and as well the quality that you kind of get is great. You've got players like Ash Sohn going out and playing these, some of the cajons and stuff, so they've got some big endorsees behind them as well. ABS tambourines, got your Fuego series starter bongos, and djembe. A Macabell cajon bongo. It's interesting. So it's a little bit of a percussion for you there.